lots of teachers and coaches and all other kind of motivational influential figures will tell you that you have to set goals if you want to make progress. And I do think that that is true, but I think there is a question you need to be able to answer before you can really even get to the point where you're setting goals. And that is the simple question, what am I working on right now? Now, as you know, I'm a guitar teacher online, and so it is in my best interest to keep all of you as engaged with guitar as possible. Here is the problem. I'm not your boss. I am not paying you to practice guitar for me. In the case of my members, it's exactly the opposite. They're paying money in order to be able to study my courses. And when you're a kid and you have teachers and you have parents, or when you're an adult and you have a boss, it's not hard to stay focused when you have an authority figure telling you, hey, this is what you're working on right now. This is your priority. But as I mentioned in a previous video, when you don't have that external pressure kind of confining your attention, it's really easy for your attention to kind of spread out like water overflowing the banks of a river or something like that. And so I wanted to talk to you about this topic today because recently I experienced this in my own life, and I think that it applies to guitar as well. Around the end of the year, I try and put out a course around Christmas time because I've learned a long time ago, people find money to spend at Christmas. And if you're not selling something, you're leaving money on the table. So I always try and have a nice course around Christmas. And that provides a great clarifying focus for me going into the last 3 months of the year. But I've noticed a trend that when the new year rolls around, I've just finished putting out a course. Usually that's the best sales season, so I'm the least worried about money or anything going into the new year. And I tend to find myself all of a sudden in March or April, and I'm thinking, what have I done for the past 3 or 4 months? And I can point to 1,000 little projects, but I haven't accomplished any one great thing. Like if you look at the scale of creativity and work that is necessary to finish one of those courses for the end of the year, compared to the magnitude of anything that I end up doing between January and April, sometimes May or even June, it's like not even close. And I was trying to figure out, why is it that I can't seem to accomplish anything great in those first few months of the years? And I realized last year that part of the reason is it comes down to focus and channeling creativity and channeling effort. At the end of the year, there is one clear thing that I'm doing. I am putting out this course. It is my singular goal. And so all my creative energy, all my focus goes into that one course. And there's never a day when I wake up and I have to figure out what to do. Until that course is done and it is out, it is the answer to every question. But as soon as that course is done, I wake up to a blank page. And the error that I've made in the past, and this is kind of what I want to talk with you about, I waited for circumstances to put something on that page for me to know what to work on. I didn't intentionally choose it. And so what would happen some years is I would spend most of the year doing miscellaneous projects, whatever, kind of like the squeakiest wheel gets the grease. So I'd put out some fires here and I'd add some features to my online player here, and then I'd get fired up and I'd do some free lessons here. But I would just like bounce around like a pinball in a pinball machine, just bouncing from one thing to the next with no clear direction. Then the end of the year comes and it's like, oh, Christmas is coming and I have to buckle down and I focus everything, and then I can put out something amazing in just sometimes a few short weeks. And so I realized that I was relying on external influences to focus my energy when I had to. But most of the year, those external influences aren't there. And it's up to me to pick what is on that page. It is up to me to determine this is what I'm working on right now. If you don't have Christmas season kind of forcing you to focus on a course, you need to force yourself to focus on a course when the new year hits. That's what I've realized for myself, is that there's not going to be that external pressure. If I don't provide it for myself, then my creativity is going to be like that water overflowing the riverbed, the river's edge, and it's just spreading out all over the fields, and it loses all of its power when it gets spread out over too wide of an area. So what I want to challenge you with as a guitar player is that because you don't have a guitar boss, because you have lots of areas of your life already that are probably structured for you, depending what kind of job you have, depending on whether you're in school, you have lots of different parts of your day that you don't have to pick the direction. It's already established before you get there. You run the risk of coming home to work on guitar and there's no boss, it's just you. And while that feeling feels good, I think what we fail to realize sometimes is that there is a paradox of being able to choose between a lot of different things. There's an example, I forget what book it's from, but they use the example of blue jeans, Levi's jeans, whatever. They said, you know, 50 years ago, there were two different kinds of jeans or whatever, and you just bought whichever one you liked better and you were happy with it. But now you've got 100 different brands you can choose from, and it makes it harder to actually be happy because one of those types of jeans had damn well better be perfect. Because you have so many to choose from, you expect one of them to be absolutely perfect. And I think the same can be true when it comes to guitar lessons. It's very easy to kind of shop around and look for the perfect thing to learn. And another phenomenon that goes along with this is FOMO, fear of missing out. You're working on something, and the first time it doesn't seem perfect, you're worried that you're missing out on something else. And so it's a real problem when you have almost unlimited number of things that you could be studying. And what can happen, and I'm betting what has happened with a lot of you, is that you've gone through a period where you've circulated a lot through the guitar lesson community. You've circulated from point A to point B, this teacher, that teacher, this video, and you've picked up little tips and tricks here and there, but you haven't made any real progress. And what I'm suggesting is that if you can't answer this question, what am I working on right now? What is the thing that is the answer to that question every morning when I get up? If it is up to you to choose what that thing is. But if you don't choose, you are going to be, you know, passed around like a pinball on a pinball machine from one thing to the next, like a moth choosing, you know, which lamp or which candle to fly towards with no real purpose. And look, it's no fun to make our lives more structured than they have to be. Part of what I love about running this business is that I don't have a boss, and I can basically do whatever I want every single day, as long as in the long term, I'm producing enough value for my members and enough value for those of you online that you'll consider signing up someday. But what I've realized is that freedom is a double-edged sword. And I have the ability to go for extremely long periods of time without having that one thing in front of me. If I don't specify it, I get 1,000 little things done, but no real sense of accomplishment. And I need that. to stay motivated. I need to be able to look at something I've built. It's just part of my wiring. So if you're like me, if you're a person who is a little bit rebellious, you don't like being told what to do, you enjoy freedom, you might want, it's worth asking yourself, am I rebelling against setting my own rules because I don't want to feel like I have a boss? And is that actually what's best for me? Is it actually better for me to just bounce around from lesson to lesson, from course to course? Or would I be more satisfied and get more positive feedback from my own working guitar if I would just pick this one thing that I'm going to focus on? And I'm not telling you never to change it. Let's be clear. I'm not telling you to pick one course and stick with it for a year. It is okay to change which thing you're focusing on. But what I'm suggesting is that if you do that, do it on purpose and do it intentionally. Don't do it as kind of as something you do subconsciously. Again, going back to my own work experience, when I don't have that big course in front of me, what will happen with my working time is I'll think of, hey, what if I built this feature for the online player that my members use? And I'll sit down one evening and I'll start coding some JavaScript and writing some new templates. And in my mind, I haven't decided yet. I'm just kind of, you know, like a kid in a candy store, just kind of walking around. No, I'm not really aware that I've started a new project. All I'm doing is doing the activity, coding and planning, designing interface. But I haven't in my mind accepted, hey, this thing, if I make it my thing, is going to dominate the next 3 weeks of my time. What I'm saying is, don't be like me and just sit down and start casually working on something. Look at what it is that you started working on and decide, is this going to be my one thing? Or am I going to have two courses that I alternate between? But these are my two things right now. This is my one, or these are the two things that I'm focusing on. Do it on purpose. Do it intentionally. And when you have that one thing, then you can get around to actually setting a goal within the constraints of whatever that one thing is. So I don't know if this is helpful. It has been helpful for me in my working life, behind the camera, off camera, whatever, as I do everything necessary to run Texas Blues Alley, to bring more content to you. I found it extremely helpful to say, hey, this little thing that I'm working on, this isn't just a little activity. This is a project, and a project needs to be finished. It's not going to get finished unless I make it my thing for maybe it's a day or 2 days. But do it on purpose. Be the same way with your guitar studying. Pick a thing, make it your official focus for as long as it needs focus. And if you decide to choose on purpose. Don't just wander from here to there, because your creativity and your work, if spread over too large of an area, doesn't amount to very much and doesn't have much potential to change your life. But if you focus it, you can reap really great rewards in a shorter period of time. So I hope that's motivating. Until next time, thanks for watching.